tragic over the ages. Romeo and Juliet. Romeo will be played by Mark, and Juliet will be played by Christina.
A long time ago, in a faraway place, there lived a king and his wife, who had a beautiful daughter named Juliet. She grew up to be a beautiful, charming young lady, and had many young men who were very interested in taking her hand in marriage. This caused a problem to her parents, since they didn't want just anyone to be her husband. They wanted a man of royal blood, one who was of their own kind, their own race, and their own social stature. This is their story.
There you are, princess, and you look beautiful as usual.
What good is beauty without love? What do you think of love, nurse?
Oh, princess, I'm sure you'll meet your true love someday, and that day will come soon enough.
Oh, I hope so. But what will this man look like? Will he love me because of who I am, or will he love me because I am a princess?
I'm sure that when the time comes, you will know, princess, you will know.
Meanwhile, in another room in a palace, the king and the queen were having a conversation.
Well, dear, what should we do with our daughter? I don't want her just to marry anyone. Do you have anyone in mind?
What about Prince Persia? He's pretty rich, isn't he?
Why, of course. He'd be perfect if he wasn't so old. But what is age matter, eh? It's the money that counts.
Let's plan a huge party and invite the prince. We'll set it up so they meet and maybe even partners during the dance.
Splendid idea. Why didn't I think of that?
Because you're not me, dear.
So the banquet was planned, and the guests started arriving. He just allowed the uninvited guests to wander in the party. Then the big moment arrived. When the king and the queen and her daughter was introduced to the guest.
Ladies and gentlemen, presenting the queen and the princess.
As they walked past the guest, each one bowed their respects, except for Romeo. He didn't even know where he was. The prince's beauty and charm swept him off his feet, so that he could barely breathe, much less move. He has never seen a woman so beautiful. Her very presence filled him with awe. As Juliet walked past him, she too noticed something different about Romeo. Alas, someone her age was at the party. There was also something so different about him. He looked so handsome, so honest. His eyes, his stunned look, his hair. But to her disappointment, she was introduced to the prince.
Juliet, dear, this is Prince Persia.
Glad to make your acquaintance, sir.
Please, the pleasure is all mine.
Oh,
gad, where did they get this clown? The pleasure's all mine. What a cliche. Why do mom and dad always set me up with guys like this? And I have to be nice to them. Fortunately, I only have to put up with them for one evening. Oh, this is going to be a long night.
But before she could get comfortable with her thoughts, however, the king called out the musicians, and the dance... The king called out the musicians, and the dance started. So for now, all they could do was stare at each other. And stare, they did. that Juliet couldn't concentrate, and Romeo just could not take his eyes off her. Second dance was over, the prince became very irritated at the fact that Romeo and Juliet just could not take their eyes off each other. He did not really want to participate on the third dance, and so he walked out. Romeo, not wanting to miss this opportunity, came right in and stood beside Juliet.
Glad to make your acquaintance, Princess Juliet. My name is Romeo.
What are you doing here? You're not supposed to be my partner. My dad would kill you if he saw us.
Yes, but it would be a well worth death if I could only dance with you, princess.
Thank you.
prince got jealous and decided to cut in. After which, the king got really angry and kicked Romeo out of the dance. Over, everybody went to sleep, tired out from the party that evening. But everybody was not asleep. The two lovers were up. That evening, Juliet, all Juliet could do was toss and turn, so he decided to get out into the night. Romeo couldn't sleep either. And as Juliet looked out of her window to look at the stars, she cried out,
"Oh, Romeo, Romeo, wherefore art thou, Romeo?"
Surprised, she heard a voice.
"I am here, my princess. I couldn't sleep either, so I thought I'd come see you."
And there, on that courtyard, that enchanted evening, they talked about their love and their devotion. They talked about their likes, their dislikes, their passions, and then their fears. After a few hours, Romeo said,
"I've never met anyone like you, Princess Juliet. Will you marry me?"
"Yes, I will. But how are we going to do it? You know my parents would never approve."
"We can elope. I know a priest who can marry us right now."
And so off they went to find the priest who would marry them. The friar was... Waking the friar from his sleep, they begged him to marry them. They explained their situation. They were very much in love, but her parents would never agree to such a marriage. They have to be married now if they're going to get any leverage. After carefully thinking about it, the priest agreed.
"Can you please kneel?" "Place your hands on the Bible. Do you, Romeo, take Juliet to be your wedded wife?"
"I do."
"Do you, Juliet, take Romeo to be your wedded wife?" "You may now hold the bride."
The two lovers walked off in their wedded bliss. The very next morning, in the palace, the nurse and Juliet were having their morning conversation.
You look like you've just been to paradise and back this morning, Princess. Did you have fun at the party last night?
Oh, nurse, last night I met my true love, my prince, my knight in shining armor.
So you did like Prince Paris?
Oh, no, not him. Last night I met my Romeo. He is charming, he's so kind, and oh, he's so handsome.
Romeo? I don't recall seeing a Romeo up there last night.
Oh, yes, you did. He was the one Father dragged out of the party. My father doesn't know it yet, but I married him last night.
You what?
You don't tell him, will you? Please don't tell him.
What you do is your business, Princess. My lips are sealed. Now we must hurry if we're going to make it to the king on time.
And so Juliet got ready and rushed to her father's quarters. There was Mom and Dad waiting to tell her the good news.
Did you enjoy the party last night, my daughter?
Yes, Father. It was a great party.
We have exciting news for you, Juliet. News I'm sure you'll be happy to hear.
What kind of news?
Well, the prince and I have agreed that you'll get married with him.
Juliet, you don't seem at all happy at the news. Is something wrong?
I don't love him. I can't marry him.
Oh, in time you'll love him. Your mother fell in love with me after a while.
Who's this person in your love with? Do we know him?
His name is Romeo. I danced with him last night.
What, my daughter? You married a peasant? Oh, you better get out of here before I get mad.
Neither the king, the queen, nor Juliet could be consoled that day. This seemed to be a no-win situation. The king or the queen would not budge in their decision. If there was anyone who needed to change it, it would be Juliet. This is what she decided to do.
Come now, Princess, it isn't that bad. You'll get to love the prince someday. And besides, you'll be set for life.
I may be rich for the rest of my life, but what is life without love? Please leave me alone, nurse. Oh, Romeo, Romeo, why can't our love be? The first time I taste of heaven is when you were taken from me. I cannot marry another. It would only hurt me, and most of all, it would hurt you. Please understand that whatever I did it for you. Goodbye, Romeo.
The palace was buzzing with the news of the death of the princess. Since most people did not hear what happened, they were even more curious why their beautiful princess would kill herself. Meanwhile, in another part of town, the priest was looking for Romeo. When he found him,
Romeo, my son, I have terrible news to tell you. Your wife, she's committed suicide. No one knows why she did what she did. Don't blame yourself, son. Congratulations. Call me for me.
My dear Juliet, why did you decide to take your life? I would have been happier to see you alive, even if you were someone else's wife. But now, you will never come back, and you and I can never be. Oh God, please forgive me this one sin that I do. I can't live without her. Juliet, take me where you are. I did this for love.
Give the cast of Romeo and Juliet a big hand.
Thank you.